Well, here we are again, this time under the watchful eye of none other than Columbus Tustin, the founder and namesake of the city of Tustin, California, where we are now. The historical marker says he worked as a carriage maker, miner, farmer, postmaster, fruit grower, and real estate developer. In 1868, Columbus Tustin and Nelson Stafford purchased 1,300 acres of the Rancho. Tustin subdivided a portion of the land, laid out the streets, sold lots, and then offered free lots to those who agreed to construct buildings to fulfill his vision. Right now, Columbus Tustin is telling me to take my electric bike and go pick up a burrito for dinner. And not just any burrito, but possibly the best burrito in all the city of Tustin, if not the entire county of Orange. So let us heed his words of wisdom and ride on, for he is the very founder of this town. Hey, the banner up there says the concerts in the park are starting. And my understanding is the lineup includes a Rolling Stones tribute band. Just in case you're interested, let's take a swing through the Civic Center. City Hall. We won't ride up to the door of the police station. They might not like people doing that. Thank you. Okay, enough touring around. Let's get serious about getting that burrito. Trying to cross over here. We're back on Main Street now and getting ready to enter the usually busy Newport Avenue. And it's not exactly a bike-friendly street, as you'll see. To be honest, this is not going to be the most scenic and relaxing ride I've taken. We need to ride to what you might call the other side of the tracks. Well, figuratively, it's the other side of the 5, Interstate 5, the freeway that cuts right through the middle of town. And for at least part of the way, we can ride on this pseudo bike trail that's really just a sidewalk with a line painted down the middle. And we'll just have to dodge any people or street furniture that we might encounter. Here's the 5 freeway. You know, when you're riding a bike, some of the most hazardous places are the freeway on and off ramps. All right, we have arrived at our destination. At one end of this somewhat sketchy shopping center is the original taco factory, which proudly promotes its tacos al carbon on the sign above. But despite its solid taco offerings here, I usually opt for the steak burrito myself. If you come here, you'll just have to make your own decision. Or better yet, just get some of each. I guess you could use the term hole in the wall, but I just think of this place as an alternative to the ubiquitous chain fast food that you can find anywhere. This is authentic. Burrito with steak, black beans, spicy, and to go.
Steak, black beans, hot or mild?
Hot.
Hot, okay. Anything else? Okay, nine.
This place has about the best salsa and pico de gallo around here. Some chopped onions and cilantro. Don't worry, I'm going to use all of this.
Thank you.
97. That would be me. Thank you. Ah, a thing of beauty. Mission accomplished. Let's go. So it's back on Newport Avenue. Okay, back at Main Street, and we'll cross Newport Avenue here.
Wait, Newport. Walk on it.
Here we have a curb and gutter that's pretending to be a bike lane. Hey, thanks for riding along. Here's a couple of other bike adventures that you might enjoy. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have a burrito to eat.